Hello, welcome back. In today's video, we'll talk about different poultry diarrhea, what the color tells you, how to treat it, and the general prevention tips. Also, we'll be giving out a bonus trick at the end of this video. Before I go to these conditions, please subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. The first one is watery or foamy diarrhea. It occurs when a very loose foamy droppings is observed, which can indicate toxins, for example, moldy feed, internal bleeding, or severe disease. Heat stress and poor water quality may also cause this watery or foamy diarrhea. The treatment is that the first one is you should include an activated charcoal or toxin binder in the feed for 3 to 5 days. Also, you have to provide vitamin C and an electrolyte mixed in the drinking water. The third one is you remove any suspected feed that is meant to cause this and replace it with fresh, clean feed to ensure waters are sanitized. And the second disease we are talking about, or the second symptom we are talking about, is the yellow diarrhea. This often indicates coccidiosis or bacteria infection such as Clostridial enteritis. It may also appear when digestion is disrupted by stress or feed changes. The treatment of today's is that for coccidiosis, you add Amprolium 20% powder at 1 gram per 2 liters of drinking water for 5 to 7 days. And secondly, for bacterial infection, you give oxytetracycline at 1 gram per liter of water for 5 days. And thirdly, you follow up with a probiotic supplement to restore a healthy gut flora for your chickens. The third symptom we are talking about is green diarrhea. When this is observed, it usually comes from excess bile pigments due to rapid gut transition or an infection. Stress and other diseases can also play a role in this. The treatment is that you provide a multivitamin and electrolyte solution to support recovery of your birds. Also, if a bacterial infection is suspected, you use enrofloxacin 10% oral solution at 1 ml per liter of water for 3 to 5 days. And you isolate the affected birds to prevent spreading of this to the other birds. The fourth symptom is the white diarrhea. When this is observed, you see a whitish chalky droppings that points to a yeast or fungal overgrowth or a general imbalance of the gut flora. It is often after antibiotics or poor hygiene that these are being observed. The treatment is that you give nystatin oral suspension at 100,000 IU per liter of water for 5 to 7 days. Also, you thoroughly clean and disinfect feeders and drinkers before refilling them for your birds. And lastly, you avoid unnecessary antibiotics and include probiotics in their diet. The fifth condition or symptom that we'll be talking about is the red or bloody diarrhea. This is a sign of severe coccidiosis, intestinal bleeding, or heavy parasite load. The mortality can be high if not treated quickly. And the treatment, you administer Amprolium 20% at 1 gram per 1.5 liters of water for 7 days. For mixed infections, you use Sulfa xyline combination products at the label's recommended dosage. Also, you deworm with Abendazole at 1 ml per liter of water for 2 days, and you repeat this after 14 days. And lastly, you add vitamins A and K to the water to support healing and blood clotting. Now, as a general prevention tips, you have to ensure that the house or the coop is clean, dry, and well ventilated. Also, you should avoid overcrowding and manage flock density very well. You should follow a regular deworming and vaccination schedule. Again, you should quarantine new or ill birds before reintroducing them. And the fifth point is that you should always supply fresh water and high quality feed for your birds. Now the bonus tip is that you should always observe the color of droppings to allow you detect early problems that might be arising. You have to treat promptly according to the likely cause and consult an experienced veterinarian if signs persist or worsen. Proper hygiene, biosecurity, and timely treatment will keep your flock healthy and productive. If you found this information useful, please share it with other poultry farmers to benefit them.